Started here in the semifinal match of the elite singles. And this is between Mark Hazinski and Joey Cochran. Both players who have trained together and grew up together in Indiana under Danny C. Miller's coaching and have moved away from the state to play themselves and also to spread table tennis in other parts of America. Having played in the same club growing up, they know each other well and know each other's styles well. Both are very determined to make it into the final. Joey takes a commanding 4-0 lead in this first game, best of seven. Mark getting into it with a nice forehand shot. Mark getting into the game, winning the last 3 points in a row. But still feeling a little bit tight. Joey really targeting Mark's backhand. If he does have a weakness, that would be where it would be. Oh, nice block by Joey. Anticipated it well after he made that push. Nice counter-looping rally, although Mark is well known for having a strong forehand. Joey really forcing a poor service return for Mark and able to attack into Mark's middle. Nice shot by Joey, really staying in control of this game. Nice forehand by Mark. Joey still leads 9-5 in the first game. Both players knowing each other's games well, really able to use the best strategies against each other. Joey has four more game points. 10-6. Nice serve by Mark. Almost long, but not, forcing Joey to whiff. Joey takes the first game 11-7 in this best of seven match. Mark is sometimes known as a slow starter, so we'll have to see what happens in the next couple games. Joey is playing very strong, though, really playing into Mark's backhand, forcing errors for Mark to stay in the next match. He'll need to focus on, you know, playing his strengths, really attacking with his forehand, and limiting Joey from going after all of his shots. Joey off to a fast start. Nice backhand down the line. 2-0 lead in the second game. Joey playing strong, really staying in control of the points. Joey very aggressive, you know, jumping on every opportunity. Have to watch out for is to make sure that Joey doesn't overplay and try to be too aggressive while making errors. Mark getting into the game more, being much more aggressive. Both players have a lot on the line. $1,000 is guaranteed for the person who advances to the finals. It's a big deal. Again, Mark not pleased with that unforced error on his probably his favorite shot, that forehand. Joey staying really focused, really wanting to book his place into the final. Mistakes from both sides as Joey misses some serve returns by Mark. Big match and very close, 6-6 in the second game, and best of 7. Wow, really good rally. Joey continuing to play into Mark's backhand. Again, his weakness, if there is any, and with Joey attacking there, it's going to be very difficult for Mark to return that specific shot. Seven all in the second game, very close. Both players really hoping to book their place into the finals. Mark obviously not pleased with his performance on that last point. But you can see that maybe he's rushing a little bit. Really nice rally, Mark focusing on putting it into Joey's backhand and really controlling where the ball goes. This is what he needs to do to stay in the game and show that he is the number one seed in 2004 Olympian and he has the ability to win this tournament. Well, mistake by Joey. This miss serve is not a great time, but take it in stride. Great short game play. Nine all in the second. Oh, good push by Joey. Really cutting it hard into Mark's forehand. This is Joey's first game point in the second game. A flip by Mark, but it was great placement. You know, going to Joey's backhand, which is something he hasn't done before. Mark whiffing that backhand flip, giving Joey his second game point. Mark using the same guard he did at 9-all, where he opened to Joey's backhand, but this time Joey was ready and was able to return the shot, forcing Mark to make an error in this step around because he probably wasn't expecting it. Joey leads 2-0 in this best of 4 match. Mark will need to make some changes in order to come back and take home and take a game and get back into the match to move on to the finals. In this next game, Joey should probably continue into Mark's backhand and also keeping the pressure on. For Mark, it's important that he continues to serve attack and also to prevent Joey from really controlling all the points. From both players, a reduction of unforced errors would really help them stay in the game more and not give up any loose points. You're about to get started in game 3. Mark will serve. Some great rallies going on. Mark really getting into it, playing strong. Well, net by Joey, allowing him to take that big backhand shot. Both players fighting hard for their position in the next round. Oh, great block by Joey, super wide to the forehand. It'd be important for Mark to actually change the direction more and go less cross court. Nice defensive play by Mark. Nice counter-looping by Joey. So he's been very successful in counter-looping from the forehand side, forcing a lot of errors from Mark.
How is there nothing on that ball?
Mark getting refocused. Both players really wanting to make it to this next round. It's going to be a close and tight match. 4-4 in the third. Joey's up 2-0 in games in this best of 7. Great play by Mark, really showing his aggressive side. Misread of the serve. Mark needs to stay focused in order to come back in this game and stay in the match. Service error from Joey ties the game up at 6-6. Then Mark should probably focus on going down the line more, being a little bit less predictable, changing the speed. And that would force Joey to not give those difficult shots. Mark's surprised at all those forehand errors, usually his strength. Nice placement by Mark, not putting too much on the ball, not giving Joey too much to work with in that counter loop. Good serve return. You can watch that. Joey probably did not mean to serve that long. Really focus on the details, really important in this elite level table tennis. Good shot by Mark right into kind of Joey's body, making it difficult for Joey to get in position to counter loop it. Service error by Mark. Both players have missed one serve each this game. Joey going for a little bit too much, trying to cut it into Mark's forehand. This had worked in earlier games, but probably just too aggressive. Mark takes the third game, putting the match score at 2-1 with Joey leading. This is the best of seven. Mark's starting to play better, playing smarter. You'll see small adjustments throughout where he is placing the ball into Joey's body more, being less predictable, and focusing on varying his serves. All these small changes will really result in big changes in points. And now it's up to Joey to really adjust to those and make changes himself in this next game. This game is really crucial in the best of seven. If Joey goes up 3-1, he has a good chance of taking home the match, but if Mark ties it up 2-2, the match is still in anybody's hands. Great backhand play. Mark becoming really a lot more aggressive. Wow, great match, or great point. Very, really be staying aggressive and forcing Mark off the table. And those small errors will cost both players. You'll see there's a lot of serving short to the short forehand. Again, a great way to move the other player out of position for their next shot. Great attacking play by Joey. We'll need to keep that up to take this game. Great attacking play by Mark, some big forehands. Risky serve by Joey, but this time it paid off. Again, Mark's forehand is his strength, so it's usually pretty risky to serve long into it. A great placement by Mark in those blocking shots, really demonstrating his control over the point and his control over this game. You know, it looks like he's in trouble, but then he just very calmly blocks it to the next corner and wins the point. And I serve by Mark just barely long, forcing Joey to put into the net. Very heavy. A lot of spin on that serve return from Mark. Joey maybe not expecting that much and looping it off the end. Oh, that was a very good flip and block. Mark was just quicker into hitting into that backhand corner. Oh, great forehand. Mark really getting into the game, taking the fourth game relatively easily, 11-4. Tying the match score up at 2-2. As the players receive their coaching for the next minute, we can talk about our scorekeeper here, who is David Sakai. He is a USA TT Hall of Fame member, has been involved with USA Table Tennis for many, many years. He will be playing in the over 30 and over 40 events at this tournament, and he is the third seed in the over 40 event. Getting started, this is game 5. Match is tied at 2-2, semifinals of the elite singles event at the 2014 St. Louis Open. Well, great forehand by Joey, coming out strong in this fifth game. Joey doing a good job of forcing Mark to make those mistakes on his forehand. Again, typically uncharacteristic of Mark, as his forehand is definitely his strength. However, both of these players know each other well and can really exploit those strategies on each other. Joey forcing Mark to make those errors on his forehand, and Mark not being pleased about that. Really tight game here, 3-2. Mark now really attacking to Joey's middle, making it difficult for Joey to counterattack. Mark losing a little bit of focus here, taking the time right now to refocus and stay in the match. Joey surprised by that long serve by Mark. Really nice serve, very sudden and surprising.
Loop the serves.
Wow, nice shot by Hazinski. Really wide into the forehand. Those wide forehand shots are very difficult to return. You see more often than in other matches, the long serves have been working really well. Both players using them sparingly to make sure that they're still, surprising. but both Mark and Joey have won significant points off of serving long. And Mark probably inadvertently serving long there, probably hoping for a short serve, but Joey was able to pick it up. Mark hitting a lot of shots that either go into the net or hit the net and go out. Mark is probably missing some of that spin that he's used to. Nice combination there from Joey, who anticipated that Mark would hit into his backhand, though Mark made that error, so Joey takes a 9-6 lead. It was a good shot. Nice block by Joey, really anticipating where Mark was going. A little bit of luck on Joey's side. That edge gives him the fifth game, and he is now leading 3-2 in games. This makes it, you know, gives him really an edge in this match. As he takes the next game, he'll obviously win 4-2. For this next game, for Mark to come back, he will need to make his shots less easy to anticipate, as Joey is always seemingly right there wherever Mark hits an attack. And Mark, this might mean going down the line more, going into Joey's middle more, which had worked early in that last game, but he had stopped doing towards the end. Any of these strategies would help Mark stay in the match and move him on to the final. For Joey, it's important now not to overplay, not to want to win badly enough that he makes errors. But he's been playing very well throughout, so we'll see. And Mark playing smart, returning that serve into the middle. I think Mark has to stay focused. That backhand seemed like a little bit of a lack of focus. Stay relaxed, but really knowing how to win the next point is important. To all in this crucial sixth game. Nice backhand punch by Joey, really changing the rhythm from all of the looping. Mark really making some more of those unforced errors, and he knows it. He needs to stop that before things get too late in this match. A little bit of luck on Joey's side, an edge on that serve return. Both players a little bit anxious, a lot of service errors and service receive errors. Joey playing smart, really aiming into Mark's backhand and middle. Mark will need to do the same in order to force those same errors from Joey. Mark is down 3 points with the serve. It might be a good time to take a timeout soon for Mark, stay in the game. A nice serve by Mark, staying in, only 2 points behind at 7-5 and down 2-3 in game. A nice shot by Joey. It's kind of flat. You can see that Mark's hitting a lot of errors into the net. Nice shot, really controlled. Oh, good rally between the two of them. Both players really need to stay in the match. Once you get into these rallies, these big forehand rallies, Mark definitely has the edge, so he can try to force those in the next few points. Nice placement by Mark, forcing Joey into his forehand and then wide out to the backhand. That movement from forehand to backhand is actually also very difficult. Really smart of Mark to play in that way. Smart serve, nice block down the line. Tying the game up at 8-all. Crucial, crucial sixth game. Little scoreboard error. It's 8-all in the sixth game. Players need to stay focused. Again, $1,000 is guaranteed to the player who moves on to the finals. Eight all and 3-2. Joey has the serve, really important few points. Net. And Mark has to focus into varying his return. You can see that he actually is, you know, not going cross court, but Joey's ready for that down the line as well. Nine crucial point, 9-8. Joey has his first two match points. Mark has to play very smart to save this. Winner will move on to the final. Impressed by the calmness and determination by both of these players. Second match point for Joey, and Mark has to save this in order to stay in the game. Oh. Nice shot by Mark, deucing it, saving those two match points. And really impressive play by both players. Very aggressive on that last shot by Mark. Again, it's important for Joey to stay calm and focused and play each of these points as if $1,000 at least wasn't on the line. It's one of the tough tasks of the underdog. A little luck on Joey's side. Mark making an error on his serve and deuce. 11-all. Joey having his third match point, up in deuce, 12-11. Mark's chance to stay in the game. Joey takes the match 4-2. Really, Joey is the number 4 seed and Mark the number 1 seed. Joey will move into the finals, which will be played after the second semifinals, which is next. It's a really big one.